The Bible actually is a copyrighted book. It's interesting to find out who owns the copyright on the Bible. Who owns the copyright? Who wrote this Bible? And where did it come from? And what? And who put up the money to make it the most important book ever published on the earth, that everybody has a copy of it in their language? Hmm. Why is it so important? It has to do with the promotion of an ancient secret society and their particular agenda that they have for the world. They were the people behind Adolf Hitler who were promoting the New World Order. And then comes in America, the Bushes with their New World Order. And the Vatican talking about the coming of a new earth, a new world. And the whole New World Order is an old ancient philosophy going back into the ancient world. And it has nothing to do with any people called Israel. The whole area we call today Israel is actually Cana. And you will find that the Canaanites had a particular language called Phoenician. And the word Phoenician, going back to the ancient Phoenician peoples of the Middle East, give us to today, the Phoenician language is referred to as Hebrew. Mm. In fact, there is no Hebrew language. There is a Hebrew people that speak a language that we call them Hebrews, and therefore we say that they're speaking Hebrew. It's not Hebrew. It's a Phoenician Canaanite language. And we get the word Phoenician gives us our word phony. Comes from Phoenician. Phony and the phonics and words like that comes from Phoenician. So go back and look at the Phoenician people and you will see that what we call Phoenicia is today referred to as Israel. Israel is the ancient land of Cana in the Bible. You talk about all the horrible things that were going on in the land of Cana. And that God cursed us, the land of Cana, and said it was a terrible place, and to have nothing to do with it. That's in the Bible, in the Old Testament. Well, Cana today is called Israel. Israel is the land of Cana today. And this is why this is when you get into the words and terms of where these words come from. And the incredible story about the Canaanite religion. The priest of Cana, they would offer up sacrifices. Usually it was children. They would burn a sacrifice. They would kill the children and burn their bodies on an altar. And then, according to the Canaanite religion, they were worshiping. They said they were worshiping the sun. And the Canaanites called the sun Baal, B-A-A-L, Baal. Baal worship was the worship of the sun in the land of Cana. Go back and look at it. Today, we say that we know that the priests of Cana who were worshiping Baal, B-A-A-L, Baal as the sun, they were Baal worshipers and they would offer up human sacrifice. They would kill children and people and then burn their bodies, but they were supposed to eat part of the burned bodies. They were burning the bodies so that God could smell the flesh. He liked smelling burnt flesh. And this is what we're told in the Canaanite religion, that God says, I love the smell of your sacrifices. The sacrifices were human, so when they're burning humans on the altar, God loved the smell of human bodies burning. And so that's where we get this idea that they were Baal worshippers were eating the bodies of their sacrifices. And so they were from Cana. And so they were Baal worshippers from Cana, which gives us our word Cana Baal or cannibal. Cannibal comes from Cana worshippers of worshiping Baal, Cana Baal, cannibals. And this is what we call today Israel. Israel is the land of Cana Baal worship, the sun god. The sun being B-A-A-L, Baal, or swastika, or tetragramma, aton. All of this goes back to the sun worship, moon worship, Venus worship, the worship of the planet Saturn, the worship of the moon. All of these are ancient pagan religions, and nobody today gives a damn. Nobody seems to care. We just go along to get along, and whatever everybody else is doing, that's what we'll do. Everybody's going to the synagogue. We'll all go to the synagogue, too. Nobody seems to know when they get there where the word synagogue comes from. Everybody's going to church. Yeah, we call Christians going to church. You don't know where the word church comes from. You need to go back and get a dictionary and look at the words and what you are supposedly involving yourself in, because you're involving yourself in a dark ancient secret. And this is why the world is not getting any better, because we are based on lies, deception. There is no such a thing as an ancient Israel. There is no Lord coming back to save us. These are all ancient stories.